you go through. What you go through.
Amen. Come on, Pastor.
We have adopted ways to take care of ourselves when we go through different things.
Amen.
Self-preservation is our first law, and that is to preserve ourselves. So when we start going through things, sometimes in order to keep from being hurt, we'll throw somebody else under the bus.
Well,
sometimes when we are going through what we're going through, we will fight for survival. We'll fight with our spouse, we'll fight with our children, we'll fight with our employer, fight with ourselves. We'll fight this thing through, because when you see that if we're going to get through this, I'm going to have to fight my way through this. And sometimes when we're going through what we're going through, we get cold. We get cold toward other people.
All
right. We just shut them out.
You're right.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Just in case you don't say it again. We get cold. Cold shoulder. I ain't saying nothing to you. I want you to know I ain't going to say nothing to you. I'm just going to look at you so you'll understand and know that my look is what I'm saying.
Amen.
The old preacher used to say, you can't say amen, say ouch. But then one of the other ways is withdrawal. When we start going through some stuff, we will withdraw. We will withdraw from family, from friends, from spouses, from co-workers. We will withdraw from almost everything. If we used to go hang out with somebody, we won't go hang out with them. If we used to share with somebody, we won't share nothing, but we withdraw into our cave, and that's one of the things that men do very well, is that when we start going through stuff, we withdraw. We don't tell you. You can ask, and ask, and ask, and ask again. And if we are in a withdrawal state, chances are we're not going to tell you, because when we're going through something, we withdraw. We don't want you to see our weakness. If we're crying, we don't want you to see our tears. We want to go outside and pray. They sound crazy. We want to go outside and pray, because I don't want you to see me cry. And so we withdraw, and I know that from personal experience, because one of the ways that I historically have dealt with, you know, issues and things that I was going through was to withdraw, and needless to say, I drove my wife to confrontation. And there were times that she had to tell me, I don't know what's going on or where you are, but this vacation that you own, you need to call it to an end and come on back. She would be loving and kind and everything, but she was trying to call me to reality because of how I was going through what I was going through. See, some people, when they start going through stuff, they will withdraw from church. They withdraw from serving. They withdraw from singing. They withdraw from ushering. They withdraw from participation. You know, if they used to sit toward the front, they start withdrawing and moving closer to the back. They start withdrawing from the circles of people they talk to. They start licking their wounds and start feeling like, I'm not there. And so withdrawals begin to come in and play a big part. And many people do not handle what they're going through in the right way. So consequently, if it's not handled well, then you continue to go through what you're going through because you didn't go through it well in the first place. Doesn't it just drive you crazy that you just went through something and you're going back through the same thing all over again? And see, I'm talking to some people in here right now. You've been going through some things and you thought you had remedied it, but you're still going through the same thing all over again. Well, the problem just may be that you keep doing the same thing expecting different results. It ain't worked yet. It ain't gonna work. If withdrawing has not fixed it, withdrawing is not gonna fix it. If cussing somebody out did not fix it, then additional curse words consider how we go through what we go through. Because if we're going to give God our best, then we